unbelievable. You know, a lot of people ask me why I decided to challenge Goldberg to a no-holds-barred match. But before I answer that question, did you see him stand in the middle of this ring and talk about ending my life? I mean, Goldberg said verbatim, I'm not only next, but that no holds barred match gives him a license to kill and that I am dead. This kind of behavior is not befitting of a WWE superstar. It's not befitting of a WWE Hall of Famer. And it's not befitting of a father, which Goldberg claims to be. I mean, who do you have? Do you have somebody standing in front of you dressed like a million bucks every week who has defended this WWE Championship the entire year? Or do you have this man that came in here with cut off sleeves on, frothing at the mouth, screaming about murder? Really classy, really classy. To which is why I have challenged him to a no holds barred matchup. Because I can't go into a match, into a fight with a man that is screaming, frothing at the mouth, acting crazy like some kind of rabid animal. The icon of Goldberg has been reduced to a rabid dog. And although Goldberg has a strong bite, that dog needs to be put down. And that crown jewel with no rules and no holds barred, I will finally end Goldberg's career. No longer will Goldberg be running into Raw, prancing into here, trying to beat somebody up and then riding off into the sunset. Oh no, this won't happen again. And I tell you what, one more thing, Goldberg, there will be no misunderstandings. There'll be no misunderstandings. Because Goldberg, you can't beat the Almighty. You can't hurt the Almighty. And Goldberg, you damn sure can't kill the Almighty.